Behind me here is yet another big reveal here at the 2019 Thailand International Motor Expo, and it's the latest Nissan Almera. Forget your uncle's old Almera, this is an entirely different beast altogether. So, let's check it out. Now this new Almera is based on the latest common modular platform that's also shared with the new Nissan March and Kicks crossover, as well as the Renault Clio and Captur. So it's a very, very modern car throughout, and it looks that way too because this has a very, very sharp new design. If you come around in the front, you can see this very, very big V-motion grille and these sharp LED headlights on this top spec VL model. Now down here you can see that even this range stopping model has only 15 inch alloy wheels, but we've seen spy shots of the car in Malaysia which gets the full 16 inch two-tone alloy wheels, which look a lot nicer. Along the side you can clearly see the inspiration it gets from the newer larger Nissan sedans such as the Altima in the US. Now at the back, this car is again very sharp and modern looking. You can see that there are arrow-shaped taillights. These are LED units on this car. Up here you can see the C-pillar is slightly blacked out to give it that floating roof look that Nissan is very famous for these days. To me, this is by far and away the best looking B-segment sedan out there. The new City looks a little bit cheap, a little bit unfinished, so this is definitely a winner in my book. Now let's talk dimensions. While this car looks quite compact, it is quite a bit larger than the previous model, but it is still a little bit shorter and a little bit narrower compared to the new Honda City. But having said that, its wheelbase is longer than the Honda, so there should be a lot of space inside. Inside, again, the Almera looks very, very modern in terms of design with this gliding wing style dashboard in front. You can look here, there's quite a bit more soft touch materials on this dashboard here compared to the City. And in the middle, there's a large 8-inch color touchscreen. And this one supports both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto as well, unlike the Honda. There's a lot more tech here as well, including this very, very big 7-inch display in the instrument cluster next to the speedometer. And that shows you the rev counter as well as a lot of other vehicular functions and data as well. The long wheelbase means that there is a lot of space at the back. And if you look down here, there is a USB charging port down here. Just the one, unfortunately. And there are no aircon vents on this model. Now the boot is again very big, just like most others in this segment. And again, there's no folding rear seat on this model, but you can expect Malaysian models to have that as well. Hidden underneath all that mess of wires and hoses is a new 1-liter turbocharged 3-cylinder engine. Again, just like the City, this meets the latest EcoCar 2 regulations in Thailand. It makes 100 horsepower and 152 newton meters of torque, which is slightly less than the City, but not by much. And it's paired to a Xtronic CVT. Now the other big addition over here is safety. This car has, I can't believe I'm saying this for a Nissan that's this cheap, autonomous emergency braking. You can see that there's a radar underneath this Nissan badge over here, and that helps it detect other vehicles. This is unlike the City, which does not come with autonomous emergency braking. However, as standard, this car only gets 2 airbags, and you have to fork out this top range VL model to get 6 airbags. So there you have it, the brand new Nissan Almera here in Thailand. I think it's a looker, and it's also packed with a lot of kit and tech on board, at least over here. But what about in Malaysia? If a Darren Tanto Moto can price this well and equip it with a good level of standard equipment, I think this could be a very, very good sales success back in Malaysia as well. But what do you think? Let us know in the comments section. Until next time, thank you for watching.